Find high-performing keywords faster than ever while you're already searching YouTube using TubeBuddy's free Search Explorer tool. Hello, Tube Buddies. When searching on YouTube, normally, you'd only see the video search results. We wanted to expand those results by bringing in some of the features from our Keyword Explorer right within the YouTube search page. TubeBuddy Search Explorer takes information from behind the scenes and brings it to the forefront. To get started, you'll need to search for something on YouTube. Let's search for YouTube growth. Once you search for your topic, you will see the list of video results as normal. On the right-hand side, you will see TubeBuddy Search Explorer, which contains a ton of useful information. You'll see the keyword score, keyword stats, related searches, and the most used tags from the top-ranking videos. It's important to note that free users will be limited to the first three results for related searches and the most used tags, and will also not have access to the weighted score. But stick around to the end of this video to learn how you can get a free TubeBuddy trial. Now back to Search Explorer. First, we'll take a look at keyword score. Keyword score is a breakdown of how many people are searching for the term, the number of searches per month, how much competition there is for this term, and an overall unweighted score. If you already know our Keyword Explorer tool, you may wonder what's the difference between Keyword Explorer and Search Explorer. Keyword Explorer and Search Explorer provide some of the same stats, like an unweighted score. However, you see Search Explorer when you're searching for videos within YouTube, where Keyword Explorer is its own separate tool. Keyword Explorer gives you a more personalized look at certain keywords, including a weighted score for our pro and higher users. The search volume score is based on the number of people searching for that term. You'll see that the term YouTube growth got a fair score. Next, you'll see that there are about 11,200 people searching for this term per month. Next is competition. And we can see here, Search Explorer is giving us a poor score. This means that there are a lot of videos and creators competing for this specific term. It also could mean that the top-ranking videos are from large channels, and they're getting a lot of views, making it difficult to get your video ranked. TubeBuddy takes all of this information and uses our own algorithm, plus YouTube's data, to give you an overall score. This score is unweighted and does not take into account your channel's specific size or performance. If you'd like your more personalized weighted score, you'll need a TubeBuddy Pro or higher license. If you have that, you can learn more here. We get a lot of questions about this score, and it's important to look at the colors like a stoplight. Red means stop, and to take a deeper look if this term is right for you. Yellow means to yield or slow down, and proceed with caution when it comes to using this keyword. Green means you're good to go ahead and use that keyword. If you're in the red, you want to try to move this needle to yellow or green. Speaking of moving, let's move on to keyword stats. Keyword stats shows a brief analysis of the channels and videos on the search results page. Keyword stats shows you the most and least amount of views per video on the search page. It's important to know which video has the least amount of views, since that's the minimum amount required to get your video showing on the first page of search results for that term. If you're not able to get that number of views normally, we'd recommend another term, which we'll be covering later in this video. Next, it shows which channel has the most and least amount of subscribers in these results. Then you will see how many videos have the particular search term you are searching for in their titles, descriptions, and tags. The more time the keyword is repeated in the data, or the title, description, and tags, the more likely YouTube is to recommend a video for that term. The final bit of information for keyword stats is about video relevancy and frequency. Keyword stats shows you how many videos in the search results were published within the last 7 days. It also shows you which channel has the most videos within the search results for that term, and how many of your videos are in the top results. As you can see, none of our videos are in the top results, but we do hope to change that. Below this section, you will see related searches. These phrases are what YouTube auto-completes when you start typing in a search term into the search bar. Related searches are a great way to discover what people are actually searching for on YouTube, and to target more long-tail keywords. I mentioned earlier in this video that if you aren't able to get the keyword's minimum number of views, you should look at targeting another term. Related searches is where we give you those recommendations. Under related searches, you can see the most used tags. These are great for tagging your own videos, as long as the tag is relevant to your video, as well as coming up with new video topic ideas. In some cases, Having similar tags as these top-ranking videos will help you show up in the related section when viewers watch those videos, in turn, driving more traffic to your own YouTube channel. Finally, you can then select any tags you're interested in within the related searches and most used tags, and then copy them to the clipboard or add them to a tag list for use later. Search Explorer lets you see how a search term is performing without having to enter it into Keyword Explorer. We want to know, will you be using Search Explorer? Want to learn more about free TubeBuddy tools? Subscribe and ring that bell. Did you stay around for information about that free trial? Check out that video on screen now. I'm Andrew Camp from TubeBuddy, and we'll see you while searching.